Hey family, and welcome back to I Love Me, Me, Me. Today I want to talk about what the success of your relationship depends on. I have 10 tips for you, so stay tuned. All right, family, so you want to know how to have a successful relationship and you want to know what it depends on. Well, first of all, it depends on you and your partner. What are you and your partner willing to do? You both have to be willing to let the relationship succeed in order for it to succeed. The thing that you have to think about is how much you are willing to compromise within your relationship. It can't all be about you. It cannot all be about your partner. It has to be about both of you, at least meeting somewhere in the middle, especially when you guys do not agree wholeheartedly on a subject. So how much are you willing to compromise for your partner? How much is your partner willing to compromise for you, for the success of your relationship? Third thing that you have to consider is how understanding the both of you are. Again, especially when you do not agree on things, or when your partner hurts your feelings, or, you know, does something that you just don't like. How understanding can you actually be that they did not mean to purposely hurt your feelings, that they didn't say what they said in the wrong way because they purposely meant to just say something that was going to harm you or hurt your feelings? How understanding will you actually be? Number four is how much you are focusing on what your partner is doing right versus what they're doing wrong. The fifth thing that you have to think about is how much respect you are showing towards each other. How much respect are you giving to your partner? How much is your respect that your partner giving you? Yeah. This will absolutely determine the success of your relationship. What you are willing to give versus thinking about what you are getting. Because if both of you are in the giving mood or in the giving of making sure that your partner is pleased with you and they're making sure that you are pleased with them, how could the relationship not be successful? Number six is how much you actually are showing your partner the love the way that they want to be loved. Because a lot of times we are showing love the way that we want to be loved. So say, for instance, you are a person that loves and wants gifts. Well, automatically, that is the way that you are showing your partner that you love them. So you are a person that likes to receive gifts. So in turn, you are absolutely giving gifts, but that might not be your partner's love language. So you have to figure out what your partner's love language is and then show them love the way that they need to be shown love. And speaking of the five love languages, I'm actually going to do a book review in a few days on the five love languages. Okay, so stay tuned for that. Number seven is how many happy memories and moments you guys are creating together. So you can think about them, and this is what you know has made you fall in love with your person, especially when you are ticked off with them. These are going to be the memories that are going to draw you back into your partner, the happy moments. Number eight is where you are actually able to have the insight to see the positive and negative consequences of your actions. You actually know and understand that, you know what, last time I did X, Y, and Z, they really didn't appreciate that. So maybe I should figure out a different way to handle the situation this time around. So having insight to know that the consequences of your actions, what is actually going to happen. This is absolutely going to help with the success of your relationship. The ninth one, I actually wrote it down, so I want to just read it. It says that research consistently shows that relationships are more satisfying when individuals practice mindfulness. And this is from McGill, Alder, and Rodriguez of 2016. Mindfulness is actually the art of giving active attention to the moment. It's not an easy task, but a useful one. You might imagine that individuals on the receiving end of mindfulness could actually feel deeply valued, a feeling that would foster intimacy, trust, and connection. So definitely be mindful. Be mindful of what your partner needs. Be mindful of what your partner wants. So number 10 I wrote down as well, so let me go ahead and read that one. It is to recommit yourself every day to your partner, to your relationship. This is absolutely going to help with the success of your particular relationship, because commitment is actually the number one. Yes, I said the number one predictor of satisfaction, especially in long-term relationships, according to Acker and Davis of 1992. Commitment is a cognitive choice, a decision that individuals make in a relationship. And actually, couples who renew their commitments every day in words and deed are situating themselves nicely for a long-lasting partnership. So these are the 10 tips in order to have successful relationships. Now, of course, there are more, but I just gave you some research thrown in there too. And a lot of times we don't think about how we can actually have successful relationships. We just want to jump into these relationships and hope that things work out well. But if you are not loving your partner the way that your partner needs to be loved, then you're kind of setting yourself up for a downfall if you're not being respectful, obviously, if you're not committing to the relationship, and if you're not saying, you know what, this is how relationships go. It's not all about me. So that compromise is not all about me. It's not all about my partner. It's somewhere in between. So we have to compromise and work on the relationship together. And you both have to make that choice to be there every single day.